What you should have seen is a sequence of stars indicating when you caught the fish, and you should see more stars when you're on the same side as the fish than when you're on the opposite side from them. Next, we're going to allow the fish to move according to a telegraph process. That makes this a hidden Markov model, again with a binary latent state. Now, unlike yesterday with the drift diffusion model, we will have binary observations. That is, did you catch a fish in this time step or not? Also, unlike before, you're only observing on one side, which means that the quality of your evidence is time dependent. Nonetheless, you can still use the same recurrence equations that we saw for the hidden Markov model, which expresses the probability that the fish are in a given state, given all of the measurements up till that time, as a product of the measurement probability for the fish being in a state times the prediction of the fish being in that state given the past evidence, right? We saw this yesterday. And now the only thing that we have to do is update that equation according to the fact that we're making actions that affect the world state, that is the state of the fish and us, especially us. Now we have the same probabilities, but they're also conditioned on what actions we've taken, but it's still recurrence. Now this posterior will quantify our belief about where the fish are. Now it's your turn. You can plot those beliefs using the code that we've provided. You'll follow the telegraph process and you'll update the beliefs according to the hidden Markov model recurrence equations. That's all coded for you. All you have to do is run this so that you can see what the dynamics look like. And you can do that by setting the parameters here, the probability of staying and the probability of catching fish, and running these two lines of code with those parameters in there. Okay? Have fun.